Hi and welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can set up the USB Wi-Fi adapter. So if your computer doesn't come with a Wi-Fi card and it doesn't have the capability to connect to wireless networks, then this adapter will give your computer that capability. And in this video, I'm going to show you how to set it up. I'm going to show you how to install the drivers, and then you're also going to see how you can use it on your computer. So the first thing, plug in the adapter. So once you plug it in most cases, it's going to be plug and play for Windows 8.1, Windows 10. But for Windows 7 and below, you're going to have to install the drivers. And if yours came with a driver CD, then you can just insert the CD inside of your disk drive. If it didn't come with a driver CD, then you can download it from memo.co.ke/drivers. So once you put in the CD, just open the files. And so there are two companies that manufacture these drivers and manufactures these devices. We have Mediatek and there's Realtek. So sometimes you don't know which one runs your adapter. You can try installing one. If it doesn't work, you try the other one. In this case, I think this one is by Realtek. So I'm just going to open it up. And if you're using Linux, you can see you have the Linux Realtek adapters. You have the ones for Mac and the one for Windows. So if I scroll down, I'll find the setup and I can just click on the setup. So just try one. And if this doesn't work, you try the other driver from Mediatek. Okay. So I'll go next. Just wait for it to install. Once the installation is complete, you're going to get prompted to restart your PC, and you can just restart it right away. Okay, so after you restart your PC, if you come down here, you're going to see that you have the wireless. The wireless capability has been added and you can connect to any wireless that is near you, around you, or you've created from your phone. So that's it for this video. In this video, I've just shown you how you can install the drivers for a Realtek Wi-Fi adapter. So before I end the video, I just want to remove this adapter so that I can put another one, which is a Mediatek adapter, and you'll see that the drivers don't work for the Mediatek one. So and you can see that now we don't have an adapter. Let me just see what's going to happen if I put the Mediatek adapter. You can see that after I put the Mediatek adapter, it's not being recognized by the Realtek adapters. In the next video, I want to show you how you can install the same drivers for a Mediatek adapter. So in most cases, there is no way for you to tell whether it's Mediatek or Realtek. You just have to try either of the drivers, and whichever works, that's the one that works. Okay. So if you have any questions, feel very free to let me know. And if you want to see how you can install and set up the driver to work with a Mediatek adapter, then just watch the next video and you're going to see how to install it for a Mediatek adapter. So that's it for this video. If you have any questions, feel very free to let me know. Hello and welcome back. In the last video, I showed you how you can install drivers for a USB Wi-Fi adapter, and the driver that we installed was for a Realtek adapter. In this video, let's see how to install the same driver for a Mediatek adapter. So there's really no way for you to tell. When you buy the adapter, in most cases, you're just going to find the adapter and maybe a driver CD. And if it doesn't have a driver CD, you can just download the driver CD from memo.co.ke/driver/drivers. And Once you download the drivers, it's the same content that is here within the CD. I just copied this content and I put it online for you to download. So if I open this, and in the last video we used a Realtek adapter, and in the Realtek adapter I installed this driver by going inside here and then clicking on setup. And if your computer is a Linux based PC, then you can use that. If yours is a Macintosh, you can use any of these Mac drivers. So in this video we are going to deal with this MediaTek drivers. So I'll just click here, and you can see here we also have the one for Linux, and you can install the one for Linux. But in my case, I'm using Windows 7, so I'm going to install the one for Windows 7. I'll just double click on it to start the installation process. So accept the terms, then go next. Okay, you can choose to install with the wireless LAN utility, but in this case, let me do it without. And if we don't have the wireless utility, we can just use the one that comes with Windows by default, the one that's usually down here. So let me just install it without the utility first. And if I see that it's better to have the utility, then I'm going to redo the video and I'm going to create one with the wireless utility. Okay, so let me just wait for it to install and then I'll be back. Okay, so apparently the installation is complete. So I'll just click on finish, and I don't know whether I'll have to restart the PC. Let me see. Okay, you see, I don't have to restart the PC for the MediaTek ones. For the Realtek ones, we had to restart the PC. But in this case, I don't have to. You can see that your wireless connectivity is now possible. You can just come in here and connect your computer to whichever wireless is around you. And it's just as simple as such. You install the drivers and then you can connect to whichever wireless hotspot is around you. So it's just that simple. First of all, you buy the adapter, USB Wi-Fi adapter, then you install the driver. So in most cases, if you won't know whether it's a MediaTek or a Realtek adapter. And so just try both of the drivers. If the first one doesn't work for you, then you try the second one. If the second one doesn't work for you, then maybe something's wrong with the adapter. But either of them is going to work for Windows, Mac, and Linux. For this one, we had the drivers for Mac. For this one, you don't have the drivers for Mac, but it should work by default. You just plug it in and it will automatically pick up plug and play. So for Windows 8, it will probably be plug and play. For Windows 10, it will also be plug and play. However, if it isn't, just come here, install the drivers and start using your adapter. So that's it for this video. If you have any questions, feel very free to let me know.